The global oil supply is under threat after a massive attack on oil fields in Saudi Arabia. The US blames Iran for the drone attack and is threatening retaliatory military action. Iran denies the charge, but the attack will affect almost all of us as a sharp increase in the price of crude oil is passed on at the pump. A short while ago, I asked Energy and Resources Minister Megan Woods just how much the attack will affect the global oil supply.
Well, actually, what we've seen today is not as great an impact as some analysts were predicting, even over the weekend. So the New Zealand market opened at $60, shot up to $72 a barrel, but then by the close of play was down to $66, and actually the futures was down to $58. And that's largely because the US released some of its strategic reserves, which has really countered some of the anxieties, I think, that the market was feeling earlier in the day.
How long is that going to tide us over?
Well, I think one of the things that this is a bit of a case of waiting. What we've heard from the Saudi oil minister is that there'll be more information tomorrow, and that's really around whether this is going to be a few days to restore production and get that back up and running, or whether it's going to be the 2 weeks that some people have been talking about. But I think one of the things that we do know in recent years, the global oil market has been set up to make sure that we don't have huge variations when things happen. And that we do have release valves in there that ensures that equilibrium can come back into play.
That being said, incidents like this are pretty uncommon. I see the early numbers out of suggest that 5% of the world's daily oil supply has been affected. What then are your experts telling you in terms of price at the pump for the average New Zealand consumer? What should we expect?
And look, we have been talking to experts all day. We've been talking to the International Energy Agency, which is, of course, the international agency of which we're a member, that is set up to help us manage us through situations like this. As I said, we've had a close tracking of the barrel price. What my analysts are telling me is that a dollar rise in a barrel means about a cent at the pump for consumers. So that what we are making sure is that we're keeping close to the International Energy Agency.
Right.
We're getting as much intelligence through as we can. But look, we're not even close to the International Energy Agency starting to do release of strategic reserves of the tickets that New Zealand holds.
OK, so if we're looking at a rise of $6 or $8 a barrel today, then we can probably expect a rise of 6 or 8 cents per litre at the pump.
Well, that's what it closed at, but I think the other really important figure is that futures market, the 58 cents, which actually is lower than what the market opened at today, which what that tells us in simple terms is that analysts are believing in December that oil price per barrel will be lower than it is today.
Okay. What can the government do to help if that's not the case, if things get really serious at the pump and we see significant price rises?
Well, of course, we're set up to deal with this. As I said, the international and global oil market is set up with these release valves. So one of the things that New Zealand does is it buys what we call oil tickets. So it's not hard to foresee that there could be some problems in the part of the world where a lot of our oil is produced. So that we purchase these tickets, that if there is a problem, we've got basically a month's worth of oil crude that is held offshore that we can bring in. So that it's that forward planning, really, that we can activate. But we'd have to see prices rise by about $20 a barrel in order for some of those strategic reserves to be released. So we're not close to that. I think it's a case of waiting to see what the Saudi oil minister has to say tomorrow in terms of what the likely time frame will be. Certainly, we saw the anxiety disappearing from some parts of the market today. But I think one of the things, although New Zealand doesn't really buy oil from Saudi itself, most of our Middle Eastern oil comes from Emirates. When one country in this global network
gets a massive ripple effect.
When one sneezes, everyone gets a cold.
What about if there is a sustained period of significant increases at the pump, in a worst case scenario, if you like, would the government consider getting rid of the regional fuel tax, at least temporarily?
So, look, I got some advice around this today, what's happened in the past, because, of course, this isn't the first spike that we've seen in relation to global events around international oil prices. And if we look back even to the period from 2011 to 2015, we saw that price per barrel was up to $100 to $120 a barrel. We're at sort of $60 to $70 today. We certainly didn't have tax being taken off or excise duty being taken off petrol then. And there is a really good reason for that, and that's because this income is how we pay for transport in this country. It's how we pay for projects like the Manawatu Gorge. It's how we pay for the Hamilton.
But the regional fuel tax is additional to that excise tax. So I just wonder, in a worst case scenario, would you consider scrapping that temporarily?
Well, it's not something we've ever seen in the past. It's not something we're considering. And as I said, that actually we are nowhere near some of the price per barrels that we've seen even in very recent recent times, the 2011 to 2015 period, where we got up to $100 to $120 a barrel over a sustained period of time, really over a period of 4 years. That the fact of the matter is that we still have to pay for our roading infrastructure and our transport infrastructure.